největší kariérní výzva pro jednoho, koruna šampiona a sláva pro druhého. Československý souboj o to nejcennější. Pás šampiona ve střední váze.
V hlavě se mi rodí dvě různé taktiky, buď to ukončit jako velice rychle, anebo prostě toho piráta šikanovat, drtit ho a ukázat mu, že tam je ten večer jako špatně. V oktagonu není jen jeden král, v oktagonu je nový král.
S Kličom, kvůli tomu, že si dostal bitku o titul v KSV a teraz jsem dojel, že povedal, že si nový král. Čím má se ukončit, jakým úderom, jakým KO, čo nemá KO úder. Obavím si ten pás a zoberiem si domov ďalší pás a vôbec nemám žiadne obavy z neho.
Ja ho chytím, uderím. A bude po zápase.
Lístky v síti Ticketportál a živě na octagon.tv.
Jakoby přezdívka jednoho z nich, The Iron Will, tedy Železná vůle, symbolizovala kariéru obou těchto borců. Kuzník versus Simon. Přezdívka patří právě maďarskému borci Kristiánu Simonovi, který se připravuje v EFC Gabčíkovo pod Mariánem Naděm a Ivanem Buchingrem. Ve svých 12 zápasech nazbíral 9 vítězství.
És szeretnék addig elmenni, ameddig lehet legtöbbet magamból kihozni.
Dělá v podstatě nejlépe přesně to, v čem je výborný také Matěj Mateusz Kuzník. 26-letý bojovník grinder z MMA gymu má na svém kontě 15 vítězství. Poslední dva zápasy Kuzníkovi však hrubě nevyšly. Kuzník se chce vrátit na vítěznou vlnu.
Snažím se najít ten balans, ty mantinely, a myslím, že teď to ukážu. Co si myslím o soupeři, tak přijde mi, že to není úplně 100% MMA zápasník. Může mě překvapit jakkoliv, ale já na to všechno budu připravený.
Kamil meče sami to háboru a šramírem hodně řek.
Hungarian fighter Kristián Simon, the Iron Will, training over in Slovakia, over at Gabčíkovo EFC team, under the same trainer as Ivan Buchinger, a two weight class champion here, Ivan Buchinger. So training with him, a training partner of his, you know, preparing him well for this. Ivan is actually injured right now from sparring, but these guys train together day in, day out, so it's only going to improve.
Nice.
Level. You know, 10-3, well-versed guy, well-complete fighter. Going to be interesting to welcome here to the Octagon Cage. I'm not sure if I agree on his choice of music.
I agree. Oh, chain broke.
That can't be a good omen, surely. It can't be.
So it's official, you're rooting against him.
I'm not rooting against him, that's all I said. But maybe the man up high is after he dropped the necklace. It can't be a good omen. But he looks ready, he looks stern, he looks like it's not taking off his focus.
No, I mean, he trains in that camp with the two-division champ. And, I mean, I'm sure they got some great things going on over there.
Yeah, huge team over there in Slovakia. Obviously, Attila Bay trains there as well. Ivan Buchinger, great training, great coaches. This guy, Young, coming here to show his level and show who he is. And he's going to have to, you know, put on a tough fight because he's taking on Matěj Kuzník. As we see him here, an another fighter out of Prague. Been training over with Andreas, as you see in the corner. Mateusz Kuznick making his way to the cage. From Havirov, the Czech Republic, training a lot of Jamin MMA fighting systems, but has moved recently to Prague, training-wise, to work out with the guys there. This guy has collated a lot of scar tissue in his career, you know, so anytime he takes a shot, he cuts very, very easy.
Okay.
And he bleeds a lot. If you go back and watch his fights on Octagon.tv, they're all bloody. Except for one, where he got submitted super quickly. So
expect to see some blood on the canvas today.
I'd expect it. This guy's a bit of a ground specialist, a submission guy, you know. So it was a bit of a surprise to see him guillotined in his last outing. But I feel like he avoids the stand-up just because of the amount of blood that comes from his head when he gets hit, you know.
I see.
So it's like a tactical choice.
Yeah. Yeah, and a lot of times the blood can affect even your vision. It can affect you being slippery.
Yeah, and Mateusz has got a bit of a reputation in his gym. If he takes you down, you don't get up. He's got heavy top pressure. You know, he's very good on top, on the ground, but on top on the ground specifically. A bit, you know, a horrible place to be. If Mateusz takes you down, Kuznick gets on top of you, you're in trouble. So I imagine that's going to be the game plan. I mean, I don't know the tactics. I don't know what he's got in store for Christian Simon, but that's how I'll imagine it.
I mean, when people fight Khabib, you know he's going to take you down.
Yeah,
or try.
And he's, well, he never tries. He always does. Who's Nick the slight favorite or quite a big favorite here? 26 years old, 15-7, grappling specialist taking on Christian, the Iron Will Simon, the Hungarian.
Well, he's going to have to pull that Iron Will out today if he ends up on that bottom of Kuznick.
Dámy a pánové, jdeme dál dnešním večerem. Tentokrát lehká váha, 3 kola po 5 minutách. Vaším rozhodčím v oktagonu je Václav Přibyl. Pojďme si představit oba muže. Nejprve modrý roh. 27 let, 180 cm, 70,7 kg na váze. EFC Gabčíkovo pod trenérem Marianem Naděm a Ivanem Buchingrem. 12 zápasů, 9 vítězství, 4 ukončení před limitem a 3 porážky. Za Maďarsko v modrém rohu. The Iron Will, Christian Simon. Červený roh. 26 let, 176 cm, 70,7 kg na váze. Reinders MMA tým pod trenéry André Reindersem, Lukášem Bártou a Michalem Novotným. 22 zápasů, 15 vítězství, 9 ukončení před limitem a 7 porážek. Za Tip Sport tým v rámci Nerudu a poháru a za Česko v červeném rohu Matěj Mateusz Kuznick.
Pánové, 3 kola po 5 minutách, poslouchejte moje instrukce, podejte si ruce, jestli chcete, běžte do svých rohů, hodně štěstí.
Here we go, lightweight action. Mateusz Kuznick in the red corner, taking on Christian Simon in the blue. Coming out to the center of the octagon. We expect to see aggressive takedown attempts from Mateusz.
They're just yelling Kuznick?
I believe so. He's a bit of a fan favorite. Nice right hand landed. Simon new here, octagon debut, so I can't imagine they were chanting for him.
Oy.
Nice underhook on the left side.
Kuznick here pressing the action, controlling that center of the octagon.
gets him and needs to be careful with his back up against the fence. Needs a bit of coaching up. Going for the takedown himself. Getting on top. Great work. Straight away, active on the bottom.
Beautifully done by Simon. Threw the 1-2, change levels and win again.
Yeah, it was, you know, it's beautiful, beautiful done, perfect.
I mean, that's how I like to set. That's how I like to set up my takedowns. I show you the hands first, and then I change levels and go.
Feet on the hip, nice underhook. Gets back up to his feet. Does Kuznick. Beautiful work. Turns it back around. Head position. Nice knee on the inside.
Nice. Good hustle there out of Kuznick. Get out of that position.
Claws together around the back. That body lock.
No, he's got the double underhook. See what he's got. See what he uses with it. He's gonna go for that leg lace there. Maybe. Oh.
Great balance from Simon. Spins it around. You can almost see how upset.
Yeah, that must have took a lot of energy.
Yeah, Kuznick was not pleased with that, but gets his hands back together, turns around himself. Great work. Nice knee on the inside. He's beautiful with those knees.
And he's got good head position, good shoulder, good underhook. Yeah, no, he's controlling the action here. Nice. Having good head position, throwing good knees, throwing punches, scoring points.
Yeah, nice posture. The Hungarian, Simon on the back, needs to do something to change the situation.
Well, he looks very strong here too. Like the pressure he's putting forward, Simon's having a hard time dealing with that.
Well, it's almost like the cage just becomes the ground and he's on top and he's just emitting pressure forward. You know?
100%, that's a good analogy there. You know, and he's kind of like the ham in the sandwich between the cage and Kuznick.
Getting squashed.
Getting squished. Working on that cardio.
Yeah, Kuznick doing exactly what he needs to in this fight, doing exactly what he wants. Good forward pressure. Grinding down Simon.
Nice. Simon did a good job turning there. I always say, if you're the guy on the cage, you're losing. You know, it's like being on the bottom.
100%, and that's sometimes I used to find in my career, like I was so comfortable on the fence.
Mm.
6'6", long, hard to take down, but I used to just rest there, and I was losing, and you get too comfortable, you know? So
yeah.
I feel like you see that a lot with a lot of fighters now. They're so well-versed on the cage, but they don't get off the cage.
Whee, nice body kick there by Simon.
Ducks under.
That was awesome.
Switches out, goes to elbows straight away. Does Kuznick looking for that Kimura, gives it up to throw the elbow. Nice.
He's gonna want to get his head out of there.
Yeah. Yep. See that duck under, switches sides, gets that single. Kimura grip here. Get wee, heavy elbow that wee. Hurt. Wee. I felt that one myself.
See what Simon does here, and he gets the top position. But Kuznick isn't staying, you know, isn't having it. I mean, he's giving him punches, throwing elbows, staying active from the bottom here.
Yeah, Kuznick doing a great job. He's very active. But he's on the bottom, he's struggling, you know. Great control from Simon. Swiss round to the back. Trying to separate Kuznick from the fence now with that right knee. 10 seconds back he goes. Kuznick back to his feet. Great exchanges from both guys. Shows the level here. Swing and a miss.
That was nice.
Very advanced stuff going on in those grappling exchanges.
Yeah, I was surprised Simon actually was the one pressing those grappling exchanges on Kuznick. I thought Kuznick would have been the one doing that.
Yeah, and you saw when Kuznick had him up against the fence, that's where he wants to be, that sort of distance, you know, right close together. Like a ham sandwich, I think you said, right?
Yeah.
Here we see quite a significant shot landing for Kuznick. Good feint. I just love the level changes of Simon. His level changes were just so well timed and very fast, you know?
Yeah. Oh, a good wrestler has good level changes like that. And his shot was great. Right here. Boom.
Yeah, just the speed to, and the awareness to change level like that, you know, in an instant. And just the forward motion of Kuznick, they just collide, but he's in the position to get the takedown.
All right, round number two. I wouldn't know who to give the last round to.
It's close. They both
it was
had
close.
Their
they both did have their moments.
Yeah, the chant is definitely Kuznick on the crowd. He's fishing for that. Kimura gets those elbows off again. Big shots.
Oof. Oh, those look rough.
His head is going to hurt in the morning.
Yeah. Bunch of lumps in the morning.
But to no real result there for Kuznick. Now he's on his back, getting pushed up by Simon. Simon couldn't convert the takedown. Gets that hands together. Nice reversal.
We almost got that little knee there.
Referee asked for action, but this is, you know, excruciatingly tiring, this work here. Pummeling back and forth on the fence. They're working hard, these guys. Simon's dropping down for this takedown on that single.
Yeah, they are. Although it doesn't look like it when they're up against a cage like that, these guys are pressing and pushing hard.
Using a lot of energy, a lot of force. It's probably one of the most tiring parts of the game, you know, is the wrestling, and especially the cage wrestling.
The grappling exchanges, yep.
In these awkward positions, you know,
yeah.
You're asking a lot from your body. Kuznick extending that elbow and that shoulder.
He's doing a good job of keeping that kind of like half Nelson there.
Referee on top of them about grabbing the fence. Good work. Kind of using that right leg as a guard inside. Nice work. And manages to finally get on top.
Oh, wow.
This is what we've heard about, this top pressure, relentless pressure. Let's see if Simon can deal with it.
Yeah, it's interesting. Simon isn't even trying to get his hips up, getting to his feet. Like, his hips and his feet are free here. So that top pressure must be the real deal, man.
Yeah, now he's trying to go to the back, but gives up the single.
And he ends up in that same position.
Yeah.
Gotta be a little frustrating, huh?
It's a weird position this for Kuznick. He seems quite comfortable in it. Like with that right leg, how he's using that right leg to control.
Yeah.
He's back to the front headlock.
Let's see what he does. Let's go to guillotine. Tries to go for the back.
Big shots, big shots.
Yeah, Simon's got to get out of here. He's got to do something.
Simon does well to get back to his feet, but he ate a lot of shots doing so.
He is... Yeah, I mean, this just doesn't look fun.
One of those grueling, horrible fights. Huh?
Yeah, I mean, Simon is not having a good time there. I mean, the pressure, the punches that Kuznick is bringing is relentless.
Bit of frustration from swimming for that guillotine.
I feel like he I don't know. He seems a little lost there.
But he gets the reversal now, pushing Kuznick up, but let's see if he break away and see some striking. Significant strikes. 105 from Kuznick, 15 from Simon. Literally 10 times the amount.
It feels like he's doing the bare minimum in these exchanges, you know?
And most of those significant strikes, I think, are elbows to the head. like from that strange single leg weird back saddle position, whatever it is. Simon looks like demoralized.
Absolutely, he looks a little lost there.
He just looks like, whoa, I don't want any more of this.
Yeah,
go away, go away.
Get this guy off me. Oh my.
Wait, nice knee, good idea.
That was nice.
Trying to mix it up because he's tired of this pressure, this forward pressure.
Yeah, he's wearing that exhaustion too.
You see that with silly mistakes like that. Bad suicide attempt at a takedown. Now this is where he doesn't want to be. Kuznick, side control on top. Big pressure here, almost has got a...
costly mistake for Simon here. Yeah, I mean, he looks like he almost didn't want to be there anymore.
I feel like his soul was crushed as they separated. He just looked at him like, oh.
That was the perfect word. He looked demoralized, like.
Look, even now when they're in the corner looking at him, look at his
he needs to bring that iron will out, baby.
Yeah,
come
we
on.
Need to see that because you look demoralized and upset and you look like Matheus Kuznick has taken your soul.
Yeah.
And he's coming for it again in the third round. You better believe it.
Look at him. Calm, cool, and collected. Breathing good.
Nice takedown defense. And these strange positions, I think, for Kuznick, you know, using that lace. And just shots from everywhere. You know, he was punishing Simon the whole time, even in this takedown. This right leg, how he's using it to hook.
Yeah.
Very effective and different, you know?
High level there. Knees to the body. You can see his experience, his intelligence in there is paying off here. Round number three.
You can see Simon moved to an 8-1 underdog.
Wow.
So the bookmakers seeing the same thing we're seeing. He looks worried in there, but that, you know, sometimes if you back someone into a corner, they can be more and more dangerous.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Those are some of the most dangerous types of people. He's got nothing to lose at this point, you know.
Well, he seems to be getting his rhythm back a little bit, kind of smiling, smirking on his face. I feel like Kuznick is kind of laying him off a little bit here. Letting him back into this fight.
He's being smart. I think he's being smart in his approach here in the third round. Doesn't want to do anything crazy because he knows Simon's got his back up against the wall in this fight. And he's going to try to do something crazy.
And gets that takedown again. Been very good with completing those. So gets the top position, but really going to need to look for a finish, I feel. Kuznick, feet on the hip. Nice. Got that double bar fly.
Oh, that is surprising.
Yeah, 5 takedowns for Simon. Coming out the back door. Great work from Kuznick. Maybe going to go to the back. Go to that maybe electric chair. Sweep.
Nice try.
Oh, in a tough spot now. Simon on top.
Use it. I'm over here coaching. You gotta use that underhook, son.
Get to the knees. Simon in control on the ground now. Good control from the back. From
yeah, this is surprising given that Simon was pretty freaking tired. He managed to pull out the takedown here in the middle of the mat.
I feel like Kuznick let him back in. He let him recompose, let him get confident again, let him feel calm.
That is true. And I was thinking, you know, he was taking a smart approach to this third round, but it cost him. He let Simon recover.
Now Simon just sitting here throwing these body shots is not enough. You know, you need to look for a finish. You need to try and progress. You need to try and get Kuznick out of here because I feel like he's 2 rounds down. And doing this just might not be enough for him. Great work from Kuznick to get separation. Needs to be careful he doesn't give up his neck or his head as he comes back to all fours. Does well to get that underhook in the dogfight position. And we're back.
Nice.
We're back to Kuznick style. 3 down.
It's like he just decided, like, all right, I'm done.
Yeah, okay. Let's go back to round one and two.
Right. All right, I'm done laying here. Let's go.
I'm just sort of impressed with Kuznick, how he can always hand out damage, always hand out shots. Always.
No matter what position he's in, right?
Yeah, he's always trying to cause damage and score points. He's never just trying to hold on.
Which is important, you know, scoring points. Those little shots, they're nothing. They're not going to knock him out, but they're scoring points.
He's got to be up in 130, 140
exactly.
strikes. That's a lot of strikes.
Yeah. Ref calling for some action here between the two. Kuznick is just fine with just staying here in the up against the fence.
Yeah, he's happy here. This is home.
Scoring points.
Nice cheeky little knees inside.
Mm-hmm.
Just doing enough to keep it here, you know? Just doing enough.
Ref keeps calling. Ref keeps calling for that action, though. And he's done with it.
As we move into the last minute, can Simon pull something off?
Ooh. These guys have been in a damn battle, man. Look at them.
Yeah, it's been a real war. Simon said it was going to be a war, and he wasn't lying. Real tough fight for him tonight. Kuznick.
They're talking to each other.
Stop running away from me. I don't speak Czech, but I'm guessing that's what he's saying.
What's going on here?
Lazy shot.
Interesting. Maybe he's really tired. Both of them are, I'm sure.
Gets out of that neck. Maybe this DAS attempt, front headlock. Has only got 10 seconds to make it work, though. Is he going to go for the alligator roll? Simon, too aware, moving backwards. And we see the end of the third round. Impressive beatdown put on display by Kuznick. Simon just couldn't find his rhythm, I feel like. I just think consistent work, consistent shots from Kuznick in any position, wherever he could be. That's got to take the victory in my eyes.
Yeah, no, and Simon was kind of rallying back in that third round, you know, pulled out his iron will a little bit, but just Kuznick is just too good.
Yeah, beautiful takedown.
Look, he went for that takedown, yep.
You know, he wasn't not in the fight. He was there, you know, he was trying to do things, but it just was never enough. And we all ended up back here in these weird, twisted positions where Kuznick was comfortable and just always causing damage, always trying to hit him. There you go again, more shots.
You know, from every position.
And when you're not used to that in training, you know, it can really stifle you and freak you out, which I feel like it did.
It was a good fight by
141 shots.
You were close.
135 of them were significant. You know, big shots to the face, a lot of elbows.
You called it.
Great work by Mateusz Kuznick. We'll be happy with that performance and happy with that victory.
There's the coach, Andre, right?
Yeah, Reindeers.
Once again, like we said earlier, we were going to see quite a bit of him today.
I believe he's got one more on the card. Let's take it to the cage and make it official.
Dámy a pánové, známe vítěze tohoto souboje, kterým se na body 29-28, 30-27 a 30-27 stává Mateusz Kuznick. Ty si chceš sednout, jo? Sedni si, to je skvělý.
Mně to bude trvat 4 hodiny, jestli ti to nevadí.
To je ten věk, jak říkáš, ale...
Přijdi na soukromku.
Přijdu, ale já mám rád to v postoji.
Já vím. Já jsem chtěl, ale soupeř se mě furt snažil házet, tak jsem čekal na jeho takedown. Viděl jsi, ne? Tak...
Viděl jsem, no tak jako náročný zápas. Byl těžší Kristián Simón, než jsi myslel, nebo to bylo přesně takový? Vlastně jsme nevěděli, co od toho čekat, kromě tohohle scénáře, který jsme všichni čekali.
Byl těžký, ale já jsem to věděl a nesoustředil jsem se ani tak na soupeře, jako spíš na sebe. To je pro mě důležitější a to byl klíč k vítězství.
Po těch dvou porážkách strašilo tě to trošku v hlavě, že nesmím udělat chybu, nepustit se do něčeho, co bych mohl nabídnout a tak dál, nebo to tam vůbec nebylo během zápasu?
Upřímně vůbec. Pár dní před fightem jsem koukal na YouTube a lidi tam říkali, že mě to bude svazovat. Chvíli jsem se dostal do hlavy, ale rozebral jsem to a bylo to v pohodě. Strašně jsem si to užil, fakt strašně.
Tak perfektní. Někdo, koho by si spřál příště jako vánoční dárek od Octagonu?
To ne, ale nechci nějakou pauzu. Za 2-3 měsíce bych už rád fajtoval.
Tak jo, Mateus Kuzník, gratuluju moc. Zpátky v zelených číslech.
Jsem dost unavený, ale musím to říct. Děkuju moc rodině, trenérům, kamarádům, sponzorům. Tihle lidi mě utváří a jsem průměr těch 5 nejbližších, co kolem mě jsou, a já mám super lidi. Myslím, že jsem se našel a tu mi pomohla moje skvělá druhá rodina. Tady stojí a taky tady zápasili někteří. Takže díky moc za tenhle klub. Jsem strašně rád a šťastný. Děkuji. A taky díky Octagonu. Organizace a fakt tu rád zápasím upřímně, jenom víš, moc rád.
Děkujeme moc, čím kdy mluvíš, tím je to lepší, Matěj. Matěj Kuzník, jeden z velkých vítězů dnešního večera, potlesk pro něj.
Jeden z nejočekávanějších střetů v kleci, jaký Octagon kdy zažil. Odložené finále Octagon Underground dvou československých rivalů.
Nepřemýšlí, nic neřeší, vypustí všechno, co v sobě má. A myslím si, že to není úplně nejlepší styl.
Matěj Many Peňáz. V kleci dosud smetl vše, co se mu dostalo do cesty. A proti němu tvrdý slovenský bijec poháněný srbskou krví. Vlasto El Chapo Čepo.
Nebojím se ničeho, jdem tam prostě ne na Česko.
Takže Matějka, jdeme rozměnit na drobné, jako jsem hovoril.
Já si myslím, že mě nikdo nerozmění na drobný, že jsem velká bankovka.
Rozjetý Matuš Juráček dostal přesně to, o co si řekl. Diamantového čáva z Bratislavy, Roba Pukače. Obávaný denverský grizzly Jeremy Kimball se konečně vrací. A bude čelit španělské KO mašině Danielu Toledovi. Splácet dluhy ve jménu svého gymu se chystá super talent Tichota. Po skalpu Růžičky a Gabala je na řadě mladý polský kat David Kareta. A chybět nebudou. Královna undergroundu Tereza Bledá. Dvojka žebříčku lehké váhy Ronald Ronny Paradeiser. Bajný německý kelt Christian Jungwirth. Nezastavitelná šampionka výzvy Lucia Sabová. Nebo záruka těch nejatraktivnějších zápasů. Miroslav Inquisitor Broš. Jubilejní Octagon 30 v brněnském Bobby centru. Lístky v síti Ticketportál nebo živě na octagon.tv.